Welcome back, student. In the previous lecture, we have gone through the skin effect and physical significance of the line. Today, it's a time to discuss certain numericals based on the transmission line. These numericals sometimes ask in an examination for 8 to 10 marks. Very simple numericals that we need to solve. So they are depending on line parameter. So let's understand the first numerical. See, there are two types of numericals which can be asked: type 1 and type 2. What is type 1? Type 1 means, see, first of all, try to understand what is primary constant and secondary constant. Then we'll talk about type 1. So when primary constants are given, primary constants are nothing but R, L, G, C. That's it. R, L, G, and C are called primary constant of the transmission line. And secondary constants are Z naught, gamma, gamma means alpha and beta included, lambda and V. These are secondary constants. So if primary constants are given and secondary constants are asked, it is nothing but the problem of type 1. Type 1 problem means primary constants are given and secondary constants are asked. So in this particular problem, primary are given, secondary are asked. In certain problems, secondary constants are given and primary constants are asked. This is a type 2 problem. We are going to see both the types of problems. So first of all, let's look at this particular problem, how to solve this. A generator of 1 volt 1 kilohertz, so this is the source voltage, supplies power to a 100 kilometer long line. So this is the length of transmission line, terminated in Z naught means characteristic impedance, and having following parameters. So since it is terminated in Z naught, it can be treated as infinite line. The concepts are already clear to you. R is 10.4 ohm per kilometer, L is 0.00367 Henry per kilometer, G is 0.8, if it is not visible it is 0.8, it is 10.4 × 10⁻⁶ mho per kilometer, C is 0.00835 × 10⁻⁶ farad per kilometer. Calculate Z naught, alpha, beta, lambda and V. It's very easy to calculate. So either it is a type 1 problem or type 2 problem, only two formulas that we require. So this is the first formula. If you just remember, Z naught equal to root Z by Y, and another formula we require, it is gamma equal to root Z by Y. That's it. If you just remember these two formulas, you can solve at least half part of this particular numerical. How to solve that? Let's solve it. So if you know these two formulas, you can solve type 1 and type 2 numerical on primary and secondary constants of the transmission line. So the first is Z naught equal to root Z by Y, which is asked. But what is capital Z? Capital Z is equal to R plus J omega L. We have gone through this in the general solution of the transmission line. That's why even I told you that if the options are available, don't attempt that question. But unless you know that particular thing, you will not understand that what is this Z and how we are getting that particular Z. So the first equation, I will just drop part of this board. So Z equal to R plus J omega L. You can put omega is equal to 2 pi f. Frequency is known to us. Yes, it is a 1 volt 1 kilohertz generator. So if it is a transmission line, a source voltage is given, something like this, and this source voltage is operating at 1 volt and 1 kilohertz. Okay, so this is 1 volt and 1 kilohertz. So frequency is known to me. Can I calculate capital Z? Yes, I can. So I have calculated capital Z as 10.4 plus J. This is R value, 2 pi f, frequency is 1 kilohertz, so 10⁻³, this is 10⁻³ plus 3 into 0.00367, this is L, which is given in Henry per kilometer. If you calculate, you will get it in terms of Z equal to X plus IY, that means rectangular form. Can you calculate it into the polar form? On your calculator, if you have calculator in your hand, you just press shift minus sign for conversion of rectangular into polar, and shift plus sign for polar into rectangular, or vice versa. So it is given in rectangular form, you need to convert it into the polar form for our understanding, and this is very easiest method. So Z is equal to 25.3 at an angle 65.72 degrees. So this is the thing which we got. Next, calculate Y. Y is equal to G plus J omega C. Once again, put the value of G. G is given as 0.8 × 10⁻⁶, and C is given as 0.00835 × 10⁻⁶. So put those values here, you will get it in the rectangular form. Convert once again into the polar form. So I got polar form as Y is equal to 52.46 × 10⁻⁶ at an angle 89.12. Okay, now I have got the value of Z, I got the value of Y. Now let's put this into the Z naught formula. Let's call this as equation number one. Put the values of capital Z and capital Y into equation number one. What I will get? Z naught is equal to 25.3 at an angle 65.72, and Y in the denominator, 52.46 into 10 raised to minus 6 at an angle 89.12. Try to understand this polar formula. Just divide 25.3. This is the magnitude at an angle. So this is R at an angle theta. So R1 at an angle theta 1 divided by R2 at an angle theta 2. So if certain form of this polar equations are known, you might have studied this in the mathematics also. Divide R1 by R2. The value you will get it as 694.45. Now, division of angle means you need to subtract denominator from the numerator. So 65.72 minus 89.12, and all these things are in the square root. That's why it is given raised to 1 by 2. So all these values are in square root. I'll just rub this part of the board. So all these values are inside this square root. Okay, if I just rub this 1 by 2, it is something like this. So inside square root, what you are supposed to do first of all, 6.72 minus 89.12, the angle you will get. But since this angle is inside the square root, you need to divide that angle by 2. Is it okay? So you will get certain angle 23.4, something like that. And the angle divided by 2, you will get the answer as 694.45 at an angle minus 11.7 degrees. This is the value of Z naught. This is secondary constant. So from the primary constant, you have calculated secondary constant. Let's solve the next part. Already you have calculated capital Z and capital Y. For calculation of Z naught, you have divided. In this case, you need to multiply. So multiply 25.3. This is a value of capital Z. This is a value of capital Z. This is a value of capital Y. So multiply angle, multiply the magnitude 25.3 into 52.46 into 10 raised to minus 6. You got the value, some value at an angle 65.72 and at an angle 89.12. So if in the division we are subtracting the angle, in the multiplication you need to add the angle. So 65.72 plus 89.12, you will get certain angle. Once you get that particular angle, what you are supposed to do? This is inside square root, so you divide angle by 2. You cannot take square root of angle, you need to divide the angle by 2, and you get some answer in the form of R at an angle theta. But I need to represent it in terms of what? Rectangular form, that is x plus iy. So if I want to represent, I need to convert, use your calculator, convert polar into rectangular, shift plus and shift or minus sign, you just cross verify and try to do that. And if you put those values, you will get gamma as 7.93 into 10 raised to minus 3 plus j 0.035. Why we are converting this into the rectangular form? Since we know gamma equal to alpha plus j beta. So I directly got the value of alpha as this and value of beta as this. Direct values of alpha and beta I can get simply by writing gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta. And how I can write alpha plus j beta? If I represent it into the rectangular form. So this alpha is 7.93 into 10 raised to minus 3 napers per kilometer. This is a unit of alpha, napper per kilometer. Is it okay? And what is beta value? 0.035. Its unit is radians per kilometer. Okay, this is attenuation constant, this is phase constant. Once that is clear, let's calculate lambda. Lambda value you already know, it is 2 pi by beta. So you will get 2 pi upon 0.035, 179.52 kilometer. This is a lambda, this is a distance traveled for one cycle, complete cycle. So in one complete cycle, it will travel a distance 179.52 kilometers. You know, if the frequency is less, definitely lambda is inversely proportional to frequency. Therefore, if lambda is more, that means frequency should be less. So 179.52 kilometer, you got lambda. And what is v? This is v stands for velocity of a wave, wave velocity, which is equal to omega upon beta. And you can calculate it as 2 pi. Omega can be represented as 2 pi f. F is 1 kilohertz. So 2 pi into 10 raised to plus 3, 1 into 10 raised to plus 3, divided by beta value 0.035. You will get the answer as 179.5 into 10 raised to 3 kilometers per second. What is velocity? Velocity is represented in meters per second or kilometers per second. So this is the velocity of a wave. So it will travel this much distance in 1 second. Look at the speed. Okay, look at this particular speed. So at this speed, the wave is being transmitted inside transmission line. So I think numerical is over. Yes, we are supposed to calculate Z naught, alpha, beta, gamma and V. So this is type 1 problem where primary constants are given and secondary constant you are supposed to calculate. Is it okay? So I will just give you another numerical to solve. Okay, I have certain other numerical. Let's go through. ओके आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू गिव आंसर बिकॉज इट्स ऑलरेडी रिटन बट जस्ट ट्राई टू कैलकुलेट अ ट्रांसमिशन लाइन हैज आर इक्वल टू 6 ओम पर किलोमीटर एंड एल इक्वल टू 2.2 मिली हेनरी पर किलोमीटर सी इज इक्वल टू 0.05 माइक्रो फैरेड पर किलोमीटर एंड जी इक्वल टू 0.05 माइक्रो मो पर किलोमीटर डिटरमाइन जेड नॉट अल्फा बीटा एट 1 किलोहर्ट्ज़ So once again, primary constants are given, secondary constants are asked. Apply the same formulas, try to get the answer. If the line length is 100 km, determine the attenuation and phase shift of the signal. So we'll talk about this particular half because up to this point you can calculate as earlier method. Only new part is from this point onwards. If the line length is 100 km, calculate the attenuation and phase shift of the signal. So we'll do that in the next lecture. So till then, thank you very much and happy learning.